involve your legs in the motion to be a sweep. Okay, so if you cross mount, and he reverses the situation, even though it's bottom to top, that is not 2 points. What he's got to do to get 2 points, he's got to get his leg involved and then turn to fight over. That's a sweep, not a reversal.
Okay.
That's how you get 2 points. Okay? To pass the guard. He's going to pass the guard.
Wish I could see you.
And then when he locks it here, he stabilizes for 1, 2, 3, and he gets his points. Everybody got that? I'll write it down for you later so you understand. Okay. All right.
Pass guard, 3 points. Sweeps are 2 points.
And this is a good point. You have to actually be in a guard to pass the guard, right? So a lot of guys get takedowns and they don't really have a guard going, and the guy passes. Takedown to the cross mount is not 5 points. It's a 2 point takedown. Okay, to establish, how you doing, man? To establish a guard requires about a good 3 seconds. Like if we're down here scrambling, he's down, and then he gets his legs in, 1, 2, and he's got a guard. You know what I mean? And he can be playing an open guard, but as long as he's keeping him in control with his hips and not letting him get around, that's still guard. I give him about 3 seconds and I'll call that a guard. But say in a takedown, he just took him down and he doesn't really establish guard, he passes real fast. That's still 2 points. You don't get the guard pass. But if it takes him down, and then he starts using his hips and stopping him from going around. Okay? Then that's a guard pass. You got to establish a guard to pass the guard. That makes sense? Okay. The only division that allows all submissions, and everything that allows all submissions, is advanced no gi. In the gi, there's no twisting locks, no pinnacle cranks. Nothing alive. Okay? Purple belt above, you step up to calf crushers, to knee bars, to toe holes like that. But no twisting locks. Even to the black belt division. Okay? Alright. In the no-gi, all of us agree on this. There's no twisting locks whatsoever in any division lower than advanced. And also, there's no neck cranks or calf or knee crushers, less than advanced. Because the referee said due to injuries, and I agree.
I mean, we want
to keep this as injury-free as possible and safe for everybody.
So now we're going to start working.
Okay, well, most of the competitors are on the mats. Do you have any questions? All wrist locks we count. And three.
Wrist locks pretty common.
Wrist locks are pretty common, like an Achilles lock or anything, you know. If someone don't scramble out of it, like if, for example, if he's cross mounted and he gets his hand pinned inside and the guy makes a wrist lock out of that, man, at any level, that's pretty fair that you can get out of that. You know what I mean? Get out of that, please. So his wrist is getting caught, so he's just going to pull his hand out. So a wrist lock's a pretty safe joint. It's not nothing that's going to twist or break.
That's not true.
Yes. Control that. Right. Any other questions? Okay. And then now we'll do here's the positions, okay? The cross mount, if the guard's established, is 3 points. Okay, if he mounts him full, that's 4 points on a 3 second control. If he switches the knee on belly from here, this leg is up with this knee off the ground. This knee cannot be down. Down, please. And that does not count. It's got to be up with control. And 1, 2, 3, 2 points. Okay? And a lot of guys like to switch back and forth to get 2 points, you're not going to do that. lot of, as I've seen this in tournaments and their actual request is, it's just not fair. If he's down in a crossbody position, and he brings his knee up, makes knee on belly, he brings it back down, he brings it back up, he brings it back down, he wants 2 points every time. Okay? He gets the points one time. Okay, now the back mount. Once the hooks are established, whether it's body triangle or hooks, you get 4 points. Just like the mount. This is the rear mount and you have the front mount, right? Any mounted position is 4 points. Okay? Okay? That's the mount. Okay? Agree? There's S mounts from there. There's a lot of things we can get more advanced, but the advanced guys are already doing this. Okay? Yes. Look. He's going to take you down, but you're going to try to pull guard. If he's in forward motion like that and you jump guard, guys, you're going to lose 2 points if you jump guard. All right. He switches angles and the guy's in forward motion and he turns. And now he jumps guard. The guy's circling. He's not in forward motion. Does that make sense to you? But what happens is a lot of guys that have not wrestled or doesn't do takedowns in their academy, okay, which is still grappling, a part of what we're doing, they try to avoid the takedown by doing this. He starts, just wait a second before you go maybe back there. He's just running backwards. He's going in forward motion, making underhooks, 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 and the guy jumps. The takedown was coming. He just tried to avoid it by jumping guard. Well, you evaded the position, you lose two. It's a takedown. Okay, but if he circles out of the position, he's standing still and he jumps, that's a guard, no points. Make sense? Okay, but what I mean by evading, if you stand up please, like he's coming in and he's getting me here, right? And if I jump guard, we know now that I lost 2 points. But say I circle out and then stop and then I jump guard, then I'm safe. Make sense? Okay. Draw for YouTube. Okay. All right, guys, everybody, if you clear off the mask, we're going to get the tournament started. Are there any more questions?
Here we go.